Hey there, it's Harith Himanshu from Bonsai Labs. Welcome to the series on JavaScript. Today in this video, we will do hands-on programming to work with the DOM, or the Document Object Model. If you haven't seen the previous video where I introduced the DOM basics, click on the card here and watch that one first. It will help you gain the visual understanding about the DOM. Alright, so as you see that I have opened up the Google Chrome. Here is the source code for the page that we are looking right now. And we go back to the page and we look at the developer console. Let's type in this.document. So when we do that, the entire page is selected and we see the document element being returned. Now, next thing we want to do is to type document. And if you see, we get the same document back. Now, the question is if this.document is equals the document and it returns true. So which means we can directly work with the document model. Now, let's clean things up and let's start typing in document.getElementsByTagName, and we want to find out by the tag h1, which is our heading. So when we do that and hit enter, we get the HTML collection back, which is an array. Open and we see that we have the element at the zero element. We want to get the first element out of this document query. So we say, give me the first element, and as you see that the element is highlighted, and we get the entire element back as the result. Now, we want to find out what type of node H1 is. So we'll do the result and then the dot node type, and we get the value of 1 back. What does the value of 1 means? If you open up the MDN documentation around the node type constants, you would find out that H1 is an HTML element. Now let's clean the screen and type document.getElementsByTagName, and we want to find out all the unordered list items. And within this query, we want to pick only the first item and we get the members' names as a result. Now what we want to do next is we want to find out all the child nodes in this result. And as you see, we get the items node list back, and this is the data type under the data type in DOM. And what we'll do next is we will test if the child nodes are the instances of the node list data type that we have in DOM. And as you see, we get the result of true. Now let's clean the screen and try to find out all the attributes in H1 tag. So let's do document.getElementsByTagName for H1. From this query, we are going to pick the first element in the result set and then all the attributes. And when we hit the enter, as you see, we get the named node map data type back. If you see here, the attributes are indexed by their position and also by their name. Now let's try to find out the attribute at the zeroth index. And as you see, when we hit enter, we get the lang attribute, and it matches the zeroth index in the named node map as we see here. Now we can find out if this attribute is the instance of attribute of DOM. And we do attr, and when we hit enter, we get the value of true back. Now let's try to find out the name property for the attribute at the zeroth position. When we hit enter, we get the lang back. And what's the value? As you imagine, it would get the value of en back. Now let's modify our DOM next. Let's set the background color for our page. So we'll do document.body.style.background, and you see color at the bottom. So we'll do background color, and we'll set the color to, let's say, yellow right now. And as we hit enter, voila, we get the yellow color back. Now let's change it to another color. We'll say, let's change the color this time to be blue. And when we hit enter, we get the blue. Let's change it one more time to be color teal. And as we enter teal, the page changes to the teal color. But as you may imagine, this is only the in-memory changes, and it has nothing to do with the persistence, because if you refresh your page, it loads the entire source file again. And as you see here, all the changes that we performed in our DOM, they are lost now. Now let's change the color one more time to be light blue. And as you see, the page color changes. Now let's update our heading 3. So we will do document.getElementsByTagName. We'll find the tag name for H3, and we will pick the first result in the query. We will find the inner HTML for this heading 3, which is team members, and we will update it to become, let's say, Bonsai Labs team members. And when we hit enter on that, as you see, it updated the DOM, and now our H3 has been updated to contain Bonsai Labs team members. Now let's remove the team members from the list. For that, we will do documents.getElementByName. We will find by UL tag, and we will pick the first result in the query, and we will get the first element child, as you see here it tweets, and we will call the remove method on that. So when we call remove and hit enter, as you see, the name Harith Himanshu is now gone. We'll try to call it again, and once we do that, the second team member is gone as well. If you refresh the page, the entire content from the file would create the DOM again, and all the changes that we made will be lost. And that's it. I hope you learned something new today. If you like the video, please hit the subscribe button on our channel to receive more engaging content about JavaScript every single week. Until then, keep learning new skills and apply them regularly to become an expert programmer. There is literally everything possible once you set your mind to achieve it. See you next time.